UFC 242 this past weekend, Dustin Poirier did not pull off the upset against Khabib. I feel like he didn't really show up at his best. I know Khabib's a savage and it's taken nothing away from him, but that to me wasn't the Dustin that we saw against Max. I think that he was worried about Khabib's wrestling way too much and really didn't let it go on the feet enough. He tried, he landed some shots, but hey, he wasn't there, and I think he was no match for Khabib either way. At the end, man, he just couldn't fight the hands, and the choke went under, and that was it. The guillotine attempt was beautiful, and I think some fighters would have tapped to that, but Khabib is one of the greats. I think that undefeated streak he has going is 28-0, I'm pretty sure at this point, is amazing. You know, who else is 28-0 in MMA? I couldn't name one person. You know, I know John Jones is also undefeated, you know, besides the disqualification, but it still counts as a loss, and he has the no contest. Khabib's never failed a drug test. Truly, he's got to be in the pound for pound number one debate. If not, he is the number one and one of the greatest of all time, especially greatest lightweight of all time. Conor McGregor calls him out for the rematch. I don't want to see it yet. Conor needs to prove he still got it. The guy hasn't won a fight since he beat Eddie Alvarez, you know, a long time ago. So let's get him another win. Let's see what Conor's got. Ferguson's got to be the guy for Khabib. Khabib looked like an animal. Looks like nobody can beat him. But if there's one man that can, it's got to be Tony. I think Tony's a savage. He's an animal. He's not going to quit. He's going to be in his face. That jiu-jitsu is fucking high level. So if he's on his back, he's still, I don't see him getting tapped out. I see Tony, if he does lose, is going to go the distance. I think that Khabib's going to have a tough fight with Tony, though. Really the only guy I can see truly giving him problems like that right now. As for Dustin, he said he doesn't want to fight the winner of George or Jorge and Nate. Makes sense. Jorge's his boy. But if Nate pulls that off, hey, that could be an interesting fight. Would it be a 70? Maybe, maybe not. I think Dustin needs to give it some time, though. He was very upset after that fight. Of course, it's heartbreaking. But at the end of the day, he's got to realize he fought a guy who is just a freak of freaks and a true savage who used to wrestle fucking bears. At the end of the day, he's 28-0 for a fucking reason now. Dustin needs to give it some time. I'd like to see him come back. If it's not, you know, if Nate doesn't win that fight, they don't want to do a Nate fight. And even if Nate wins, I don't know if I want to see it. I don't know if Poirier is ready for it right now. Give him somebody maybe like a Felder. You could maybe give him like the Aya Quinta Hooker winner, but even that or the loser. I just think that Dustin needs to give himself a couple months to assess what he wants to do, make a plan, and then go forward with it. I mean, at the end of the day, Khabib might not be around forever. You know, this could be, you know, not the last shot for Dustin. Dustin might get a chance at a world title again, so I don't think he should be totally discouraged and think his career is over. You know, he could be a world champion one day, but as long as Khabib is champ, I don't see Dustin ever beating him. It's just not a good matchup for him. Dustin's one of the best boxers. He's so slick. But Khabib is just too much. And Khabib might be too much for everybody ever at lightweight or to ever live. We'll see how the Tony Ferguson fight goes. And we'll see what happens with Conor and things like that. If I'm Dustin, though, give him time. He'll be back. I think he's just always going to be, you know, a top five guy at, you know, lightweight. At featherweight, the cut is too much. And I don't think he should even consider going back. I think he's too small for 70, though. I really don't think he should jump to 70. I think those guys, like, if you look at Usman and him, you look at Khabib and Usman, look at the size difference there, and you see the manhandling Khabib put on. I'm not saying Khabib couldn't beat Usman, maybe, maybe not, I don't know. But at the end of the day, I think Dustin needs to stay put at 55, give himself some time, rebuild his brand, get some more wins under his belt, keep the fights coming, keep making money, and who knows, you know, if Khabib retires, something perfectly lines up. Maybe he could fight for the title again if he puts a couple together. But that's really it for this this portion. I actually do want to talk a little bit about the Edson Barboza fight and Paul Felder. I really like Paul Felder. He's an awesome analyst. You know, I like him. He does a good job. I shouldn't say awesome. He's good. But he lost that fight. Edson Barboza won it, in my opinion. It was close, but definitely not a 30-27 either way. I saw a 29-28 Barboza. They gave it to Felder. I love Felder, you know, as a fighter. He's a good fighter. He brings the fight. He's entertaining. I don't think he really is a title threat, but maybe he'll get a big fight. I don't know who to put him against right now. There's options definitely for him, but give it some time. I mean, you could maybe see him fighting, you know, the winner of Cowboy and Gaethje. If the, you know, Conor doesn't want Gaethje or Cowboy winner, which who knows if he will. That could be an interesting fight for Barboza, man. I don't really know who to put him against. If I'm the UFC, he just lost a controversial decision. He's fought most of the best guys in the weight class. He's lost to the better grapplers, and now he lost to Paul Felder even. Yeah, he deserved the win, but at the end of the day, he had a very close fight either way. I think Barboza should give it time. Is it his end of his career? I mean, I don't think he'll ever be world champion. Sorry to put it, man. I'm a fan of Barboza. I have been since his spinning back kick knockout of Terry Edom, but I think his time is dwindling down. Make a few more good paychecks, maybe a main event or a co-main event, fight in Brazil a couple times, and finish out his career there, I think would be the best move for him. But that's it for today, guys. Thank you guys for watching this UFC 242 main and co-main event reaction breakdown type of thing. I'm going to keep making more of these. See you guys in the next one.